Hi, this is Barbara from LiveBinders, and today I'm going to show you the download binder feature. So this is a feature that's only available for the pro version of our product. So you have to have a pro subscription in order to use the download binder feature. So you go to the binder that you want to download, click on options, and click on download this binder. It asks you if you want to download it. You click on download. And this is going to take a little while to process, so you will be emailed when your download binder is ready and available. And when it's available, it will be in the download management panel. Now you can access the management panel either from here, or you can mouse over your username and access the panel from here. So you can see I've actually downloaded this before, so once it's up and available, I just click on download. And it ends up in my downloads directory. Now it's going to end up as a zip file, so you unzip that file, and then you find the HTML file in that unzip file, and it will say play underscore and the name of your binder. And so click on that, and that will bring up an offline version of your binder. So this looks exactly like your online version, except it doesn't have any of your login information up here, and it doesn't have the options capability. But you can search your tabs just like you do on your online version of your binder. Now this is an uploaded file, so that downloaded to my computer. This is now a local file, so it's pulling it from my computer. But I have a bunch of websites in here, and if I go to one of those websites, this will only be live if I'm connected to the internet. I won't see this actual website if I'm not connected to the internet. But all my downloaded documents will be there, even if I'm not connected. So that's the download binder feature. This is a great way to have a nice backup copy of your binder if you want to, and backup all the files that you've uploaded. And it's also, if you're presenting offline and you have uploaded files in your binder, it's a great way to do that too.